It's not often when you go to a fashion show and designer brings the world to you.
If you want to look chic, you must wear Chanel. It's not just clothing, it's not just a tweed jacket, it's a lifestyle, you know.
It's almost a surprise because it's huge, it's beautiful, it's each time different, and it's breathtaking all the time, you're right? Even if you expect something incredible, each time you're totally surprised.
Statement on global fashion and Chanel.
You know, it's not only Chanel, because French luxury is the only thing in the French industry that has a global impact and no crisis and nothing. Huh? The others, they don't know well enough how to get global.
And this idea of putting the globe in the middle of the room, it's like the world of Chanel, really, isn't
no,
it?
Because, you know, this is a very simple story. Chanel opened her first store in 1913, 100 years ago, in Deauville. And now, there are 300 freestanding shops in the world. When you look, there are a lot in the Middle East, in China, Japan, and all over.
Amazing.
And if those markets wouldn't exist, French luxury, not only for Chanel, would be in trouble.
We live in an era of brands, and a name like Chanel you know, conjures up a lot more cultural references and visual ideas and dreams about, you know, beautiful things than, dare I say, a lot of small countries, you know what I mean? Half the countries in the world don't mean as much to most people, and not just fashionistas, as Chanel does, so it's an uncanny phenomenon, and that kind of captured it.
Feminine clothes, but there was a great tension in the collection between like the rock and roll and the femininity, you know, with the boots. And I'm obsessed with the white gloves. I gotta figure out how to bring them into my wardrobe.
It was just so together, because what I got out of my sensation out of the show is the strength and the power of all these ladies walking with the leather boots, the cuissard, you know, and walking with like a very strong walk. And then there was the other ones coming with the sweaters, the cozy and the relaxing and vibe. And when you look at this amazing planet here, who's dark, right? It's spinning softly, but it's also got dark colors. So it's just to remind us, it's beautiful.
Something's not right. You're getting tired of this life. You just don't know how to thrive. Maybe one day you'll see life's in motion. You ought to be flowing with it.
New proportion though, with the boots and the over there. Tell me about
that. Yes, there are those leather stockings in, and sometimes part of them is even in tweed, so when you see the thing, you think she has pants, but she has not to wear tight leather pants or tight tweed pants, and then they're put into those shoes with, instead of having ribbon to they have chains, and it gives a balance, you know, there is a balance needed, because the shoulders have a certain importance, and the colors go up, and there's a lot of movement in the skirt, and this had to be balanced by something. You cannot have little stilettos, and then it would look very demodé. And then there are no red carpet dresses, you see, no fishtail, nothing. Huh? It's quite severe. The evening is not at all a fancy evening in the sense of party girl.
It's
easy. What did you want
to do? I wanted him to do something very silvery, because I removed nearly everything golden out of the collection. because at Chanel there was many gold, and everything is silver, steel, gray. So I want something shiny and bright, with all those colors going from gray to black, but shiny most of the time. There was something bright and shiny needed. They have it on the shoes with the silver chain, so that something was needed up there too. Huh? And I like the color touches of the little fur hats who were inspired by Anna Wintour's hair.
Describe how you're feeling about fashion as we look ahead into this next season.
You know, my problem is I look only in my own direction, huh? So I don't look too much in other people's direction. Huh? And my direction is what you saw.
It was fabulous.
Thank you.